Slash execute, not to be confused with slash kill, is a very useful command. While not used to vanquish your enemies, it can be used to get someone else to vanquish your enemies for you. Interested? Here's the deets. If you run the command slash help execute, you will be greeted with an unhelpful and rather uninformative block of text. So, you navigate your way to the Minecraft wiki page for slash execute, and whoa! You're greeted with an extremely informative wall of text that is somehow even less helpful than the help command was. And, wait a second, do these examples even work? No, they do not. C was replaced by count when all the commands got remade. Oh, yeah, the commands got redone a while back, so if you used to know what slash execute did, think again. Everything is different now. Nothing is the same. The first thing you need to know is that execute is not a command on its own, but rather the beginning of a series of subcommands. What are subcommands? What do they do? We'll get there. There are two categories of subcommands: modify subcommands and condition subcommands. If you're a tech man like me, you might have an idea what these are, but wait, there are also two subcommands that fall outside these two categories. One of them is extremely complex and could take up a whole video by itself, and the other one is so simple I'll tell you what it is now. Slash execute run is the simplest possible execute command. It simply runs a command. If I type execute run, you may notice this is exactly what usually pops up in the tab menu. So if I do slash execute run, and then the say command, and then type something super important, you'll see that I run the command like normal, as if I had just done slash say. Now that is pretty boring. But wait, it gets more exciting when we learn about slash execute as. Yes, this is our first modify subcommand. Execute as changes the person who sent the command to whatever player or entity you choose. So if I execute as at S, that would do exactly the same thing. That's just for the player who runs the command. You're executing the command as the player who runs the command. That does nothing. So instead, we're gonna execute as at E, run, say, hi. And look at that. Every entity has just said hi. Armor stand, 3 paintings, 4 sheep, 4 chickens, an egg, legitimoose, and one more egg. So this is useful for a handful of reasons, but honestly, 90% of the time I use execute as is when I forget that it's not slash execute at. This is actually a trick people use for building sometimes. This can actually be useful in the state that I'm about to teach it to you. So slash execute at changes where the command is run, as in the relative coordinates will be different. You guys know relative coordinates. TP tilde tilde tilde, that'll teleport you to where you are. If I change it to tilde tilde 100, that'll be 100 blocks up. You know the deal. So execute at changes the coordinates that the command is being run at. Let's first write something very basic. Execute run set block tilde tilde minus 1 tilde to lime terracotta. Beautiful. We run that, and unsurprisingly, it shows up right below the command block. Now, if we run execute as legitimoose, and then the same run set the block below the lime terracotta, it doesn't appear below me, it still appears below the command block, because even though it's supposedly being run quote-unquote as me, it is actually still running at the location of the command block. So if we change as to at, then that will run the command relative to my coordinates. Check it out. Bam. Whenever we activate it, we get a lime concrete right below us. Now, I said this was useful for building. What does that mean? Well, I'll show you real quick. If I set this to an always active repeating command block, so it's running 20 times per second every second, all of a sudden, if I just run around, it goes below me. I can fly all over the place and build a big old thing like I'm a crayon man. I don't know. Like I'm a living magic marker. Now we just turn that back to needs redstone and to an impulse command block. Very nice. Those last two subcommands that we've just learned are what's known as modify subcommands, because they modify where the command is being run. Now, if you look at the tab complete, there are actually quite a few of them. All of these subcommands are in the modify category, except for if, unless, run, and store. So let's see what we got. Let's do a speed round, because most of these are really weird. Align aligns things to, like, the nearest axis. Normally a coordinate would be in the center of the block, but if you run align, it'll line it up with a corner of the block or something like that. I don't know when that's useful. Execute anchored changes whether it's being run from the eyes or the feet of the entity that is running the command. Execute as and execute at we've covered. Execute facing is pretty straightforward. You just enter the entity or coordinates that you want to match the pitch and yaw of. These two coordinates right there. Execute if is what we're going to cover in a moment. Execute in is kind of cool. It chooses the dimension that you're going to execute it in, so by default, overworld, the end, and the nether. But as of 1.16, you can actually add your own dimensions to Minecraft. And that's pretty cool. And if you wanted to get to one of those dimensions, you would need to use execute in. Next up, there's execute positioned, which it executes something at the coordinates of an entity or block, but not including rotation data or what dimension they're in. So use that when you need it, I guess. Then there's slash execute rotated, which lets you set the rotation as either two coordinates or as an entity. And that is all of the modify execute subcommands. Yahoo! Let's move on to the good stuff. Conditionals. Oh yeah, this is where it gets fun. Slash execute if block blocks data entity predicate and score. Predicate and score are a little scary, so let's start with block. Execute if block one block below my feet is a grass block. So it's used like this, execute if tilde, tilde minus one, tilde, Minecraft grass block. So if the block below me is a grass block, then run the command slash say, I am standing on grass. I am standing on grass. What if I stand on lime terracotta? Nothing happens. It's beautiful. So you could put this in a command block and say execute at legitermoose. If the block one block below, now we're at legitermoose, so the block one block below me is a grass block, then say I'm standing on grass. But note that the command block will say I am standing on grass, not me. I'll leave it up to you to figure out why that is. Just a quick side note, you should never use slash say in a finished product. I know that you can, it would work, but just learn how to use slash tell raw. It's a better command. Slash say is only useful for debugging. Now I'm going to show you a quick variation. Instead of saying if the block below me is grass, we can change it to unless the block below me is grass, run this command. So in this case, we'll change our text to say I am not standing on grass and run it. And hey, I'm standing on lime terracotta. Now if I run onto some grass and run it, nothing happens. If and unless, they're just the opposite of each other. Now, what about those other conditionals? Well, actually, every single conditional is the same between if and unless, and that's all of them. So you can only do if or unless block, blocks, data, entity, predicate, score. We've been over this. To save myself from going overly in-depth during this tutorial, I'm just gonna quickly explain what these are. Execute if block, well, we just learned that one. It detects a block at certain coordinates. Blocks will compare two areas, so similar to slash fill. If two areas match, that command will run. Data is for JSON tags and NBT data, so if the block entity or some kind of inventory storage matches a certain data tag, then it will run this command. If you don't know what that means, you need not concern yourself with it. And entity will execute if a certain entity exists. So if there is at e type equals pig, run say pig exists. No pig exists, so nothing is run. If we spawn a pig, pig exists. And then there's run if predicate, which is far too complicated to get into. And then there's run if score, which if you're using scoreboards and you're getting to a point where you need to like carefully calculate scoreboards and do math and inequalities and whatnot, just write a plugin. And that's all of the conditionals. That's execute unless and execute if. The only thing left is execute store, and boy oh boy, execute store is a doozy of a command. I am not gonna explain it to you yet. Maybe I will someday, but for today, that's the basics. That's all you need to know to get started with slash execute. Okay, now that we're nearing the end of the video, you guys want to see something really cool? Alright, for each 3-block Neo I do, you guys gotta subscribe or unsubscribe, okay? It's gonna be like a little children's game. Alright, 1, that means you guys gotta subscribe. Okay, we're good, it's all going well. Oh, 2, okay, you guys gotta unsubscribe. Hold on, I gotta make this next one. Oh, shoot. Oh, no, that's not gonna fly. Let's do a no cuts. That's 3! You guys gotta subscribe! You guys gotta smash sub! Okay, hold on. How many can I do? We're going crazy. Alright, 4, okay. Alright, that's fine, we can make this one. I'm so good! No! Frick! Oh, it's rigged! System's rigged! Ah!